Good morning, fans of Privateer FX. Coming at you at the European Open. Beginning of July. As my esteemed colleagues in America had mentioned, it's going to be a funny week. 4th of July in America, non-farm at the end of the week, and really the beginning of the European vacation season. A fair few of my friends are already in Italy or wherever they're going. So be interesting to see how this liquidity shapes up. First thing on my mind today is Euro Yen. We're having some bit of a showdown in Germany. The interior minister that works with Merkel has offered to resign. More ultimatums in Germany threatening the Merkel's coalition. Not good for Euro Yen, not good for Euro. Especially if you think that the Euro Yen move to 129.40 was fix related and that the Euro dollar move to 116.90 was also fix related. We saw this bearish engulfing on the 1 hour chart. Top of the range, so it's not surprising to see Euro back down here, combined with some moderately bad news. And then we've got a little bit of European data today that we need to watch, PMIs, and ECB's Pratt is speaking. So we're thinking Euro left, Euro-Yen left today. How to take advantage of this. You're basically going to have to use 129.50 as your stop point, so maybe 98s, 8s, and 18s on the top side, and we trade this from the short side today. It really only starts to get interesting, really interesting, below 128.50, as in this is going to get interesting. We've already made a new high today on the dailies. So that's not technically a great sign. So we're going to keep it pretty light, and we're going to watch this news flow. We will be short Euro Yen and short Euro Dollar to start out the day. As far as charts that are interesting, all of these yen crosses, they look and feel like they're going to turn here. But the medium and long-term charts quite bullish after last week, so it's quite tricky. But 145.76, interesting in sterling yen, 84 the figure, interesting in CAD yen. And these are kind of trades where you're obligated to keep a very, very tight stop. Because as you can see on the dailies, we're in a positive bullish flow here. Sterling yen, big green day yesterday, and we're kind of looking at these sort of bigger highs. But the early action is left hand side, so we will be trying some I would say light shorts through these levels in a momentum style, with a momentum style bias, really tight stops, not marrying anything sterling yen and CAD yen. Elsewhere, let's look at cable. Big strong day on Friday, but UK PMI today, and just more of the same Brexit bullshit. I mean, UK officials are just lost. God knows what's going to happen there. But it doesn't look that great. So movements to the downside are not surprising, and it's not really strong enough yet. There's no real strong enough technical setup for topside maneuvers, so we're just watching this now, looking for setups on the 4 hourly. As you can see, it's just easing off a bit, but nothing special. We talked about Euro, and with this Merkel news and more problems with immigration, which is the reason for this move up on Thursday night or Friday morning. We could easily see this thing head back down towards 115 with problems in Germany. Dollar Swiss, 99.20. We've got SMB site deposits today. Shouldn't be too surprising either way. This gets interesting now. We've been watching all last week this 99.90 level, and through one, obviously psychologically, that's important. If that were to happen, this is going to coincide with 115.10 in euro, so it would be a quite an interesting point if we get there. But for now, no trade in dollar Swiss. Let's look at dollar CAD. Trump is like flapping around about oil prices. Oil prices are off a fair bit now. Let's see. Oil is down 1.1%. CAD is marginally higher. We printed and closed on the lows. CAD also, as Privateer US mentioned, did bearish engulfing. That's a very bearish bar on the weeklies. Weeklies are notoriously hard to trade. It's a candlestick that's notoriously hard to trade. So I'm not suggesting selling 131.35s and leaving a stop up at 134 unless you are a long-term trend following guy. And if you are, you're probably not listening to this channel, so the risk reward of that trade is very, very upside down unless you're looking for a move to say 121, which could happen, but most of us don't have the patience or the wherewithal to put that kind of a trade on. So what else? Let's look at dollar MEX after this election. Really no surprise here. Mexico is now officially a socialist country. Currency has taken the brunt basically since April. Now we're kind of at the top third of this range. No trade there. It's old news now. And lastly, let's look at Bitcoin. We all saw in the Wired document about the letter from the Bitcoin founder. Interesting read. No real new information, but there is a book coming out that we will be watching. And over the weekend, Bitcoin went higher. So our 5200s and 4200s are not filled. We're patiently waiting because we do think this is going to take one last move left. And we'll be there to scoop 52s and 42s and hold tight. Because if we get through 5,000, there's going to be a lot of capitulation, a lot of people bailing out on this. But we still like it. We're long-term buyers of this. This hasn't changed. And we will just sit core long. And tactically trading, getting our averages as close to 2,000 or 1,000 as possible. Because as you can see, it is in a downtrend here. And until that changes, we are defensively accumulating longs. All right, I've said enough. The Merkel news and the news out of Germany is giving us cause to short euro and euro yen. Otherwise, we wait and see how the numbers look. And we'll talk to you at the New York Open. Ciao.